Hello and a lovely morning once again, and great welcome to this particular session. So after having wrapped up section 2, now we shall move over to section 3. I already talked about this particular section earlier, that this happens to be the foremost and most important what we call part of this particular chapter. Lots of questions in the past have been striking in the examination, have struck in the examination already with regular frequency. So why this particular one is very important, that I will let you know in a short while. As we have already seen that this particular section deals with what we call interdepartmental transfer. Besides that, it also deals with unrealized profit. Now see, first let me actually explain this particular concept. Suppose there are two departments, one A, another one is B. Correct? We presume that in the current year, department A has transferred some goods to department B. So quite obviously A is going to put the transferred amount over here. Let us say A has transferred 1 lakh worth of goods. We further presume that cost price of the goods which A has transferred is 75,000, and A has transferred these goods at rupees 1 lakh to B. 1 lakh to B. Try to understand this point. If cost happens to be 75,000 and transfer price or selling price is equal to 1 lakh, so quite obviously the profit charged by department A from department B will be equal to 25,000. Correct? And if I will divide 25,000 by 1 lakh, I will get rate of profit on sales or on transferred price, that is 1 by 4. Remember one thing, A has transferred to B at selling price, correct? This is not the cost price, this is the selling price, and profit of 25,000 is included in it. There wouldn't have been any problem if out of these goods, nothing would have remained till the end of the year with B. Because A has transferred these goods to B, obviously B is going to write these goods towards the debit side. Correct? B is going to write these transferred goods towards the debit side. So B has received 1 lakh worth of goods. This is selling price from the perspective of the A, but this is cost price from the perspective of B. Quite obviously, suppose I sell an item to you at a selling price of 1 lakh. Now, since you are purchasing it for 1 lakh, this happens to be the cost price for you. It is quite obvious. So this is cost price for B, but selling price for A. Now, suppose at the end of the year, some closing stock is there with Mr. B. We do not know the amount of closing stock, let us say for a while, but what we know is that in the closing stock of Mr. B, let us say there are 20,000 worth of goods which have been transferred by Department A. That means in the current year, A has transferred 1 lakh worth of goods to B. And out of these 1 lakh worth of goods, 20,000 worth of goods are still with Department B at the end of the year. And this is going to give us the problem. That means in case of interdepartmental transfers, two points are very vital. Goods must have been transferred at profit margin, number one. And out of those goods, some goods should have been unsold till the end of the year. Then only we will have to compute the unrealized profit. Suppose if nothing would have remained unsold, then we would not have done any sort of calculation. Correct? Then no problem would have arisen in that particular case. So this is the first thing which you need to know. Second important point is now what is the problem? The problem is that the closing stock with Mr. B includes 20,000 worth of goods which have been transferred by A. Now, try to understand, when A transferred 1 lakh worth of goods, the profit of A increased by 25,000, no doubt about that, because the cost price of these goods was rupees actually 75,000. Now, again this 20,000, because these goods have remained unsold, so quite obviously B is going to put it towards the credit side, and we know that in these goods, there is some profit margin. What is the profit margin? That is 1 by 4. Correct? That means The profit margin included in these goods is 5,000, and these goods are also appearing towards the credit side in the form of closing stock. So you can see now the profit of the organization will increase by 5,000 more further unnecessarily. Are you getting my point or not? Actually, when A sold goods to B, obviously there is some profit. But here we are not selling goods to anyone. But still 5,000 worth of profit is increasing. So that is the reason why problem arises. So if there is interdepartmental transfer and transfer is at a selling price or at a profit margin, and some of the goods out of that have remained unsold, in that case, whatever profit margin is there in the unsold goods, we will have to extract it out. We will have to pull it out. And first of all, that profit is known as unrealized profit. Is it clear to you? Where we will adjust it, that I will let you know in a short while. Is it clear to you or not? So that is the basic problem which we are going to face under this particular topic. So now we take up some question to elaborate it further. Well then, 3.1 we begin today's session with. 3.1 interdepartmental transfer and concept of unrealized profit. So bit of idea I have already given to you. In this case, X Limited has two department, A and B. From the following particulars, prepare the consolidated trading and profit and loss account, consolidated trading and departmental trading account for the year ended 31st December 2023. Consolidated word, sometime we use when we have to prepare actually consolidated P&L account, that is combined profit and loss account, that is what we call general profit and loss account, as we did in the last question, if you remember. Correct? In this question, opening stock at cost is given 20,000, 12,000. Besides that, purchases is given 92,000 and 68,000. Sales 1,40,000, 1,12,000. Till up to this point, there is no problem. Even wages, no problem. Now, question says that closing stock. Closing stock with department A is 4,500 and it is written purchased goods. And it is also written finished goods. That means Mr. A might have purchased some raw material, and out of those, some goods have remained unsold. That is known as closing stock or purchased goods. That means if I am purchasing raw material and some of the stock is remaining, that means these goods are in the same form in which I purchased them. Whereas after purchasing the goods, quite obviously I am going to manufacture them into finished goods. And this is closing stock of finished goods, also known as manufactured goods. So finished goods is 24,000 worth of stock with department A. And similarly with department B, we have got its closing stock of purchased goods worth rupees 6,000. And finished stock is 14,000. Even till up to this stage, there is no problem. Now question states further, purchased goods transferred by B to A. Now this is important, purchased goods transfer. It is a case of transfer of purchase of goods. Remember one thing, no problem will arise, and we have to do nothing with respect to no problem. One, with respect to WRT, with respect to transfer of purchased goods. Why there will be no problem? Because purchased goods are being transferred, that means these goods are being transferred at cost. There is no margin included in it. So that is the reason, even if out of purchased goods some closing stock is remaining, it is not going to pose us any problem. Is it clear to you or not? So some purchased goods have been transferred by B to A. Obviously, I am going to write it towards the credit side of B and towards the debit side of A. Similarly, A has also transferred 8,000 worth of goods to B, purchased goods. So these goods are not going to give any trouble to us because transfer of purchased goods is always at cost. You cannot transfer them at selling price because you haven't done any manufacturing activity in it. Now, there is transfer of finished goods. Now, there is transfer of finished goods and it is important. transfer of finished goods, unless and until otherwise stated, transfer of finished goods will always mean there is some profit margin included in it. So transfer of finished goods and transfer of finished goods will give us problem when two things will simultaneously happen. One, these goods have been transferred at a profit margin, and most of the time we will see finished goods have been transferred at profit margin, and some portion of the transferred goods is still in stock. Some portion of transferred goods is still in stock. Then only the calculation of unrealized profit will have to be done. Two simultaneous things, concurrently two things must happen. Transfer of finished goods must be at some margin. Secondly, out of these transferred goods, some of the portion of the goods must be remaining unsold. Correct? So A has transferred to B 35,000 worth of goods, and B has transferred to A 45,000 worth of goods. Now again, there is some more problem. Besides transfer of goods, there is also written here return of finished goods. Sometime what happened, suppose I have transferred to you 35,000 worth of goods. Let us say in this case, A has transferred to B 35,000 worth of goods. Correct? 35,000 worth of goods. It could be a possibility that out of these goods, some goods may or might have not come up to the satisfaction of Department B. So he might have returned some goods out of this. Now here it is written return of finished goods. First look over here. Return of finished goods by B to A. By B to A is 7,000. That means B has returned 7,000 worth of goods. A had transferred 35,000 worth of goods, finished goods to Department B, but Department B has returned 7,000 worth of goods. So you better, when we will write it in the departmental trading and profit and loss account, transfer of finished goods, it is always better to write transfer of finished goods at net price. Correct? So I will write here 28,000. That means I have adjusted the return of finished goods in the transfer itself. Similarly, we have seen that B has transferred to A 40,000 worth of goods. So I will write here 40,000 worth of goods. Now look over here, return of goods by A to B, because B has transferred to A, and out of that A has returned back to B, and A has returned 10,000 worth of goods. So I will write here 10,000. Is it clear to you? So that means net transfer by B to A is equal to 30,000. So it is always better to write transfer of finished goods at net price. Correct? It is always better to write transfer of finished goods at net price. Correct? At net amount, in fact. That means transfer less return. Now we have been given carriage also. No problem with respect to carriage. Till up to this point, there is no problem. What is the problem then? Problem is that you are informed that purchased goods have been transferred. Now this is the line. Purchased goods have been transferred at their respective departmental purchase cost. I already told you, even if this line would not have been given over here, even in that particular case, I would have had assumed that purchased goods have been transferred at cost price, because purchased goods are always transferred at cost price. So no problem, and you will never ever face any problem with respect to transfer of purchased goods. Correct? However, now question says that finished goods at a profit of 25% over departmental cost are transferred. that means finished goods are transferred at 25% over cost. Correct? 25% over cost. And we know the meaning of 25% over cost. That means if department A is transferring goods to department B, that means cost is 100 plus 25. He is transferring it at 125. That means add some margin. Further, the question states that 20% of the finished goods at each department represented finished goods received from the other department. 20% of the finished good with each department represents interdepartmental transferred goods. What does it mean? It means if suppose I will see the closing stock. For example, in this case, closing stock is 24,000 and 14,000. Closing stock of finished goods. Question says that 20% of the finished goods. Now, if I take 20% of 24,000, suppose if I take 20% of it, it will be equal to 4,800. And if I take 20% of 14,000, it will be equal to 2,800. Now, question is telling that 20% of the finished goods with each department includes interdepartmental goods. That means out of 24,000 worth of closing stock, 4,800 worth of closing, 4,800 worth of stock is out of those goods which must have been transferred by the other department. That means out of 24,000, I may say 4,800 worth of stock is out of those goods which must have been transferred to us by department B. Similarly, this is department A, and 2,800 out of 14,000 worth of goods are remaining out of the stock transferred by department A. This is the meaning of this particular line. So in this question, there is transfer of finished goods. Number one, the finished goods are being what we call transferred at a margin. Number two, and some portion of the finished goods is still in stock. That is why we will have to do some calculations. Correct? So this is your section three. Section 3. Now, in this particular section, the point is that one, there is transfer of finished goods. There is transfer of finished goods. Finished goods is also known as, or should I say, are also known as manufactured goods. Number one, there is transfer of finished goods. Transfer is at margin. Transfer is at margin. That means finished goods are being transferred at a margin. And third, some portion of transferred goods, some portion of transferred goods are some portion of the transferred goods is unsold or included in the closing stock. So when all these three things will happen, and just to make you a little bit more cautious, I will also write that transfer of purchased goods is always at cost price. Transfer of purchased goods is always at cost price. So no problem will arise in case of transfer of purchased goods. Correct? Now we will solve this question. Even though it is given in a solid manner. So first, I will stretch a line. I think this much is enough. And then I write here, department A, I write here department B. Department A and department B, and I write the title departmental trading and profit and loss account. Correct? So now we can start solving this particular question. Let me create a bit of more space for me. Okay. So first of all, I will take opening stock. Now opening stock is given in the question as 20,000. I will write here simply 20,000 and 12,000. No problem with respect to opening stock. Then we have got in this case purchases. So I will write here purchases. Purchases is 92,000 and 68,000. And 68,000. Is it clear to you? Have you noted down all these things? Or you want to note? Because I have written it over there, so I don't think. Okay. So this will help me in getting space. So purchases we have written, and then in this case sales is there to the extent of 1,40,000. So I will write here sales 1,40,000 and 1,12,000. Then we have got in this case wages to the extent of 12,000 and 8,000. I will write here wages, that is 12 and 8. 12,000, 8,000. Is it clear to you or not? Then we have got in this case closing stock. Intentionally, I am writing closing stock a little bit deeper. So closing stock in this case of purchased goods and finished goods is given separately. With respect to department A, it is 4,500 and 24,000. 4,500 first of all I will write, and 24,000 then I will write. Similarly, in case of department B, it happens to be 6,000 and 14,000. Correct? Till up to this stage, I don't think there is any problem. Then, transfer of purchased goods has taken place. I've already told you, transfer of purchased goods is not going to give us any trouble. Transfer of purchased goods. So, as far as transfer of purchased goods is concerned, B is transferring, so I will write it towards the credit side of B, 10,000. And over here, I am going to write transfer, purchase goods. Because B is transferring, so department A will receive the goods, that is 10,000. In the next line, it is given that A is transferring worth rupees 8,000 worth of goods, purchased goods. So 8,000 I will write over here because A is transferring, B will receive. So on the debit side of B, I am going to write 8,000. Is it clear to you? Now we come over to important point. Transfer of finished goods. I told you transfer of finished goods is very, very vital. Transfer of finished goods, intentionally I just want to use some other pen. Transfer of finished goods. However, we have seen that as far as transfer is concerned, A has transferred 35,000 worth of goods. But out of 35,000, 7,000 worth of goods have been returned. So net transfer is 28,000. So I will write here 28,000 because A has transferred these goods. And over here, I am going to write towards the debit side of B, 28,000 worth of goods transferred by department A. Similarly, in case of B, we have seen 40 minus 10, net transfer is 30,000. So I will write here 30,000. I will write here 30,000. Is it clear to you or not? And then, towards the debit side also, I will write 30,000. So return of finished goods is already adjusted. Isn't it or not? Then in this case, we have got carriage. In this case, we have got carriage. Carriage given to you is 2,000. So you will write here 2,000. Isn't it or not? So carriage amount carriage carriage is 2000 and 2000. So you can see now we have incorporated almost every information. So we are in a position at least now to compute the gross profit. First of all, you compute the gross profit. Gross profit will be equal to 38,500 and 46,000. This will be your gross profit. Is it clear to you? After having computed the gross profit, obviously I will have to bring it down to, I will write gross profit brought down 38,500 and I will write 46,500. Unfortunately, we have gone through the entire question, and in this particular question, we didn't come across any expenses which are of indirect nature like salaries, rent, etc. So my net profit will remain same. However, this is your net profit, but subject to unrealized profit, because we haven't incorporated unrealized profit. So we have computed net profit, no doubt about that, without incorporating the unrealized profit. So below you are going to prepare a consolidated P&L account, consolidated profit and loss account. This is your consolidated profit and loss account. In the consolidated profit and loss account, you will first of all write net profit brought down of department A. Your net profit was 38,500. And of department B, your net profit was 46,500. Now, only thing is that you have to debit unrealized profit. As we saw earlier, when I was explaining the concept, that because of unrealized profit, profit unnecessarily gets actually exaggerated or increased. So, unrealized profit will have to be debited to know the clear picture of the profitability of the organization. So some workings will have to be done. So your working notes are vital in this case. I will write here working notes. In the working notes, obviously you will have to compute the unrealized profit. Correct? In order to compute the unrealized profit, you write A and B. And first of all, you write closing stock. Closing stock of finished goods. Now, closing stock of finished goods, we have already seen earlier, is 24,000 of department A and 14,000 of department B. I explained it over there also when I was explaining the question. Now, question states that out of these closing stock, 20% of closing stock with each department, 20% of closing stock of each department are interdepartmental transferred goods. What it means, now I will compute 20% of closing stock. Now what is this closing stock, 20% of closing stock? Indirectly it means interdepartmental transferred goods. Interdepartmental transferred goods. As I told you earlier, that closing stock of A is 24,000, but 20% of this, that means 4,800, are interdepartmental transferred goods. It means these goods must have been transferred by B. In fact, B might have transferred you some more goods, but out of that 4,800 are still remaining with A. So you must not forget that these goods have been actually transferred by department B. Similarly, now I am going to compute 20% of 14,000, that will give me 2,800. That means whatever closing stock is there of department B, it comprises 20%, that is 2,800 worth of interdepartmental transferred goods. That means these goods must have been transferred by department A. And we know that when these departments transfer to each other, they charge a margin of 25% on cost. So now I will have to compute unrealized profit. In order to compute the unrealized profit, I will have to write here profit margin. Now profit margin is given to you. Profit margin is 25% on cost. 25% on cost. So we will have to convert it on sales. 25% on cost, that is on sales, it means 25 by 125. 25 by 125 on sales, because these goods are considered at sales price. So, what is the unrealized profit? Therefore, unrealized profit, you will compute it in this manner. 4,800 worth of goods are unsold, correct? Out of goods transferred by B. So, B must have transferred some goods to A, and at the end of the year, 20% of these goods, actually, out of those goods, 4,800 worth of goods have remained unsold. So profit margin included in it will be equal to 1 by 5. So if I will compute 1 by 5 of this, it will be equal to 960. Similarly, profit margin included in department B, that is 2,800 into 1 by 5. Is it clear to you? It will be equal to 560. Honestly speaking, you must also understand, for your knowledge sake, it will be considered, this 960 will be considered as unrealized profit of B, because these goods have been transferred by B and we are computing unrealized profit on it. Similarly, these goods have been transferred by department A, so it will be considered as unrealized profit of department A. Is it clear to you or not? So you have computed the unrealized profit. So you will write here unrealized profit of department A. Unrealized profit of department A, as we have seen, is equal to 560. And unrealized profit of department B actually is 960. And now I will compute the net profit, and my net profit or balance carried down will be equal to 82,980. 82,980. So these calculations we have to do under concept of unrealized profit, correct? Is it clear to you or not? Interesting question. I hope so, you would agree. So on such count, hoping that you must have got a fair idea now how to go ahead, now we move to 3.2. Now 3.2 is yet another interesting question. In 3.2, it is stated that Green and Company has two departments, P and Q, correct? And further, it is mentioned that P sells goods to department Q. P sells goods to department Q at normal selling price. At normal selling price means we sell the goods or transfer the goods to department Q at same price which we charge from our customers. So obviously it means some profit margin is included in it, correct? Also, question now states that from the following particulars, prepare departmental trading and profit and loss account for the year ended 31st of March 2023, and also to ascertain the net profit. Now, as far as information is concerned, that should not pose you any difficulty. Now, 1 lakh is what we call opening stock with department P. However, there is no opening stock with department Q. So 1 lakh nil. Purchases, we have been given now 23 lakh. So no problem, 23 lakh and 2 lakh. Goods from department P. It is already written over here that P transfers or sells goods to department Q. So these goods have been transferred by department P, correct? These are interdepartmental transfers, IDT, interdepartmental transfers. Now this time it is not written whether these are purchased goods or these are manufactured goods or finished goods, in fact manufactured or finished goods, are one and same thing. So you would presume in this particular case that these are always manufactured or finished goods if nothing is written. And moreover, it is already mentioned that goods are transferred at selling price, and it is possible only in case of manufactured goods. Then we have been given wages, we have been given traveling expenses, closing stock at cost to the department. This line is given just to confuse you. Every department, when computes the closing stock, it computes the closing stock at cost price only. So 5 lakh, 1 lakh 80. Then we have been given sales, then printing and stationery. All these expenses have been given to us. In fact, all these items have been given to us so far in an allocated manner. So no problem till up to this stage. However, following expenses had been incurred. Salary 2 lakh 70. Now we will have to apportion it. And advertisement and general expenses. Now question also says that depreciation at the rate of 25% of machinery having a book value of 48,000. First of all, you will have to compute depreciation on machinery. Now depreciation on machinery will be depreciation on machinery. Since value of machinery is given to you as 48,000, 25% is your depreciation. So that is equal to 12,000. So 12,000 is your depreciation, no problem. Now question says that this depreciation will have to be apportioned in the ratio of 1:3. So in the ratio of 1:3, I will apportion the depreciation. Also, it is written that advertisement expenses are to be apportioned. Advertisement expenses are to be apportioned on the basis of turnover. On the basis of turnover, that means sales turnover, I will have to divide the advertisement expenses. Now we know that sales turnover is actually 23 lakh and 15 lakh. So I will take here 23 lakh advertisement expenses. 23:15. In this ratio, I am going to divide it. Salaries in the ratio of 2:1. So I will divide salary in the ratio of 2:1. And general expenses in the ratio of 3:1. It is clearly given that general expenses need to be divided in the ratio of 3:1. So no problem in this particular question. However, in point number 5, it is given to you that 2/9 portion, 2/9 portion of closing stock of department Q comprises of transferred goods. 2/9 portion. Now what is the closing stock of department Q? Because we are transferring the goods to department Q. Now, we had seen earlier that closing stock is 1,80,000. Now, closing stock is 1,80,000. So, first of all, I will compute 2/9 of closing stock, isn't it or not? If I will compute 2/9 of this, it will be equal to how much? It will be equal to 40,000, I think. I think this figure should be 7/9. Please make it 7/9, because otherwise this question will not strike. I think in your notes it is 7/9. Just let me actually check it up. I think it should be 7/9, correct? But we will find out, don't worry about that. We can easily find it out also. Even if this particular line would not have been given over here, I can easily find, then I will rectify it. But I think it is 7/9, correct? Anyway, we need not require to worry on that particular count. So first, we will start solving this question. So in order to solve the question, first of all, this is 3.2, case study 3.2. And then I'm going to write here departmental trading and profit and loss account. Departmental trading and profit and loss account. In this case, again, there are two departments. So let me stretch a line first of all. I think this much is enough. Okay, department P, I will write here. Department Q, I will write here. P and Q. Correct? Now we can solve the question. Opening stock is given to us. Opening stock, I will write here, 1 lakh. There is no opening stock with department Q as far as it is concerned. Then we have got, in this case, purchases. I will write here purchases. As far as purchases is concerned, 23 lakh is of department P and 2 lakh of department Q. Then we have been given, in this case, goods from department. That means some transfer. Transfers is given. Department P is transferring some goods, and goods worth rupees 7 lakh, in fact, transferred by department P. So I will write here 7 lakh. And department Q will receive the goods. So I will write towards the debit side of department Q, 7 lakh. Correct? 7 lakh. Second important point is now wages. Wages is given to you as 1 lakh and 1,60,000. 1 lakh and 1,60,000. After wages, we have been given traveling expenses. Traveling expenses we will write below in the profit and loss account. Traveling expenses are 10,000 and 1,40,000. After traveling expenses, we have been given closing stock. So I will write here closing stock. And closing stock is 5 lakh of department P. And closing stock of department Q is equal to 1,80,000. 1,80,000. Correct? 1,80,000. Then we have been given amount of sales. Sales is equal to 23 lakh and 15 lakhs. 23 lakhs and 15 lakhs. Correct? And then we have been given printing and stationery. So printing and stationery, I will write here, printing and stationery, P oblique S. Amount is 20,000 and 16,000. 20,000 and 16,000. Then we have been given salaries. And we have seen that salaries need to be divided in the ratio of 2:1, I think, in this particular question, right? So in the ratio of 2:1, you are going to divide 1,80,000 and 90,000. It is given in the question itself. Then we have been given advertising expenses. I told you advertising expenses, it is written that we have to divide it on the basis of sales ratio, that is 23 lakh is to 15 lakh. Now that will be equal to 54,474 and 35,526. Then general expenses are also given to us in the question. And question has stated that general expenses need to be allocated on the basis of 3:1 out of 8 lakh, 3/4, 6 lakh, 2 lakh. Then depreciation on machinery. We computed depreciation as 12,000 and it need to be divided in the ratio of 1:3. So out of 12,000, 1/4, 3,000 and 3/4, 12,000. Correct? So this is how all the information we have incorporated till up to this particular stage. And now we will compute the amount of gross profit. As far as computation of gross profit is concerned, that is not a big task. Gross profit, you can simply write over here 10 lakh and 6 lakh 20,000. This will be the gross profit which you will get. and then you write your gross profit brought down, that is equal to 10 lakh and 6,20,000. 6,20,000, correct? This is the amount of gross profit. Of course, now you can also find out your net profit, but this net profit is subject to unrealized profit. 1,32,526 according to the solution, and 129,474. 129,474. After having computed the net profit, now we need to prepare a general profit and loss account or consolidated P&L account, whatever you may like to write, correct? So general profit and loss account. Now in this account, I will write here net profit of department P is equal to 132,526, and net profit of department Q is equal to 129,474. Only thing remaining is that unrealized profit, and because this time goods have been transferred by department P, so unrealized profit will be of department P. Now, in this question, how to find unrealized profit? See here. First of all, I need to know the closing stock. Calculation of unrealized profit. This is my working note. Calculation of unrealized profit. In order to compute the unrealized profit, first I write closing stock of department Q. Closing stock of department Q. Now closing stock of department Q, as we computed, in fact, as is given in the question, I think it is 1,80,000. Is it 1,80,000 or not? Let me check. Closing stock is 1,80,000, correct? So I will write here closing stock 1,80,000. Now see here. Proportion. Proportion of interdepartmental transferred goods. Interdepartmental transferred goods. In closing stock of Q. For example, in the last question, we had been given that whatever your closing stock is, 20% of that comprises of interdepartmental transferred goods. But in this particular question, we haven't been given that particular thing. Now that is the problem. So I can still find out. How can I find out? Suppose I just look into the column of department Q. This is department Q, correct? In the solution I'm talking about. We know that department Q by himself has purchased 2 lakh worth of goods, and he has also received 7 lakh worth of goods. He has also received 7 lakh worth of goods from department Q. That means logically total purchases for department Q is 9 lakh, because 2 lakh worth of goods have been purchased by department Q from outside, and indirectly we can say this department has also purchased goods from department Q worth rupees 7 lakh. That mean if my total purchases is equal to 2 lakh from outside, 7 lakh from other department, correct? Out of these purchases, 7 lakh worth of purchases is interdepartmental transferred goods. Try to understand this. Out of my total purchases, 7 lakh worth of goods are interdepartmental transferred goods. So, proportion of interdepartmental transferred goods. So, I will presume that if my total purchases is 9 lakh, interdepartmental transferred goods is equal to 7 lakh. So, I will consider this proportion to find out the total closing stock which is included in it. What my point is, now I get 7 by 9. That means if my total purchases are 9, 7 are interdepartmental goods. Correct? So that is why I told you that proportion which is given must be 7 by 9, not 2 by 9. Correct? So rectify it. So anyway, now you apply this fraction on closing stock. That means out of 180,000 worth of closing stock, 7 by 9 worth of goods must be interdepartmental transferred goods. So that comes to, I think, 140,000. So 140,000 is interdepartmental transferred goods. Now we have computed it. Now problem again is that we have to find out profit margin in this particular case. But in this case, profit margin is not given in a clear manner. It is given to us that goods are transferred at normal selling price. But what is my normal selling price? So profit margin I will have to compute, because in the last question it was given that goods were being transferred at a profit of 25% on cost or something like that. But here it is not given in a very specific manner. So what you will do when profit margin will not be given, in order to compute the profit margin, what is the rule? The rule is that you will compute the gross profit, which we have computed. We will divide it by sales plus transfer of finished goods, not transfer of purchased goods, transfer of finished goods. Then we can get our gross profit margin, or simply profit margin. We have computed our gross profit, I think it was 10 lakh. Gross profit we computed 10 lakh. So gross profit is equal to 10 lakh. Gross profit is equal to 10 lakh. And my sales is equal to 23 lakhs. So I'm going to write here 23 lakhs. And further, sale of, and 7 lakh worth of sale of finished goods. 7 lakh worth of finished goods I have transferred. So 10 lakh divided by 30 lakhs, or 1 by 3. You can compute the percentage also if you want. So 1 by 3 is your profit margin. That means if you are selling the goods for rupees 3, you are earning a profit of rupee 1. So 140,000 worth of goods have remained unsold, which have been transferred by you, Miss Department P. So unrealized profit will be equal to 1/3 of 140,000. 1/3 of 140,000. That will be equal to how much? 1,40,000 divided by 3, that is 46,667. So 46,667, that will be your unrealized profit. Is it clear to you or not? So unrealized profit, all we have to do is to put it over here, and it will be considered as unrealized profit of Department P, because these goods which are remaining with Department Q have been actually transferred by Department Q. Correct? Now we can find out our balance carried down, and our balance carried down or net profit finally will be equal to 115,333. Is it clear to you or not? This is how you will do this particular question. I hope it is clearer to you now. So after having done this question, now we pick up 3.3. Interdepartmental transfer and concept of unrealized profit. Of course, we are doing that exactly. So in this question, what is given to us? Just wait. Leno manufacturing an electronic component operates with department X and department Y. Here, transfers are made between the department both of purchased and manufactured goods. Manufactured goods means finished goods. Goods purchased are transferred at cost. Now this line, goods purchased are transferred at cost, even if this line would not have been given over here, now we are well aware of this particular fact. Manufacturing goods are transferred only at selling price. Again, in this particular question, you will have to find out the selling price as per this formula. Correct? When profit margin is not given, in that case, you will have to find out the selling margins. This is important. Then transactions for the year ended 30th of June 2023 is given to you. So these are your transaction opening stock. Then you have been given sales, correct? You have been given wages, purchases, and then closing stock of purchased goods and manufactured goods is also given. Now further here it has been given that following were the transfers from department X to department Y. So department X has transferred to department Y purchased goods worth rupees 6,000 and finished goods worth rupees 20,000. These goods have been transferred by department X. Similarly, department Y has also transferred purchased goods worth rupees 5,000 and 35,000 worth of finished goods. Even till up to this stage, there should not be any problem. Stocks were valued at cost to the department. This line is irrelevant. Every department computes what we call closing stock at its cost. Only in the closing stock of manufactured goods. Only in closing stock of manufactured goods in the department, transferred finished goods are 20%. This is similar to the question which we did, what we call a while ago. So whatever closing stock with respective department of manufactured goods is there, 20% of that will be considered as interdepartmental transferred goods, and then you will have to apply the profit margin to that to find out your unrealized profit. But problem here is that in this particular question, it is not that easy to find out your gross profit. Now I will explain it, just pay attention. First of all, see, I will solve the question myself, don't worry. 20,000 I will write here opening stock. Correct. I will explain the question. So 20,000 worth of 20,000 and 15,000 I will write over here till up to this stage, no problem. Sales 1,90,000, 1,90,000, 1,35,000 I will write here. Then I am going to write what we call wages 12,500 and 7,500. So wages 12,500 and 7,500. Then purchases 1,80,000. Till up to this stage is no problem. Then closing stock is given. I will write first of all closing stock. This is my closing stock. Correct? I will write my closing stock, and it is clearly given that closing stock of purchased goods with department X is 2000 and 7000. I will write 2000, 7000, and with department Y is 5000 and 8000. So till up to this stage, again, no problem. In between, we had been given, after closing stock now, we are given following were the transfers. As far as transfer is concerned, department X is transferring. So move to department X first, correct? In case of department X, now write transfer of purchased goods, because department X has transferred purchased goods worth rupees 6,000. First you write only 6,000. Then you write transfer of finished goods 20,000. Department X has transferred 6,000 and 20,000 worth of finished goods or manufactured goods. Finished goods or manufactured goods are one and same thing. Similarly, department Y has transferred 15,000 and 35,000 worth of purchased goods and 30 and what we call finished goods. The moment you are going to write 6,000 and 20,000 towards the credit side of X, same thing, 6,000 and 20,000 will be written over here. And the thing which you have written over here, 15 and 35, will be written towards the debit side. Correct? Towards the debit side. Is it clear to you? Now, we will compute the now we are in a position to compute the gross profit. Gross profit will be equal to 59,500. We will bring this gross profit brought down over here, and then no expenses again in this particular question. So our net profit will remain same. Our net profit will remain same. Till up to this stage, there is no problem. Correct? No problem. Now we have to prepare general profit and loss account. We'll bring these profits. Now, only thing is that we have to write unrealized profit, which I have already written, but we have to compute the same. I have done the workings also, but I will reflect the workings. First of all, in this particular question, main thing which you need to know is, step A, computation of profit margin. Because profit margin is not given. I am talking about 3.3. Computation or profit margin. I will compute the profit margin. But profit margin is not given. And we know that when profit margin is not given, we apply the following formula. What is the formula? That is gross profit divided by sale plus transfer of finished goods. Is it clear to you? Now, in this case, what is the profit margin of department X? Suppose I want to compute for department X. So, profit margin for department X will be, first I will look into the gross profit, that is 52,500. Then I will look at the sales. Sales of department X is equal to 1,90,000. Then I will look at transfer of finished goods, not transfer of purchased goods. 20,000. Correct? If you want, you can compute the percentage also. It is entirely your prerogative. Correct? Suppose if you want to compute the percentage, so that will be equal to how much? That will be equal to, okay, I do not want to waste time. It will be equal to 25% on sales. Correct? It will be equal to 25%. If you compute the percentage, it will be equal to 25%. Obviously, it means 25% on sales, because below we have written sales. Similarly, now we are going to compute profit margin for department Y. Now, gross profit is 59,500. This time, actually, the profit margin of department X is different and department Y is also different. Now, 1,35,000 is the sale of department Y. And now you are going to add what? Transfer of finished goods, which is also 35,000. And you will now compute the percentage. I think it will be equal to 35% on sales. So now you know the profit margins, correct? After this, in step number B, you write here, calculation of unrealized profit. In order to compute the unrealized profit, department X, department Y, you write their closing stock. What was the closing stock? Closing stock of respective department. When we say closing stock, it always means closing stock of finished goods. Closing stock of finished goods is 7,000 and 8,000. 7,000 and 8,000. And question has very clearly given that closing stock of finished goods with each department includes 20% of interdepartmental transferred goods. So interdepartmental transferred goods. Interdepartmental transferred goods shall be equal to 20%. Now if I compute 20%, 1,400, and if I compute 20%, 1,600. You must know and must understand, you need not require to do it in the examination in this manner, just your knowledge say that these goods must have been transferred by Department Y. And these goods 1,600 which are remaining unsold with Department Y must have been transferred by Department X. Why I am saying so, it is important for you to know about all these things, because when you are going to compute the unrealized profit, for example, when you will compute unrealized profit of this department, what percentage you are going to apply? Because this time you have two percentages, 25 and 35. So you need to understand that these goods have been transferred by Department Y and the rate of margin of Department Y is 35%. That is why actually I'm stressing upon this particular fact. So 1,400 into 35%. Now, whatever it is, that will be considered as your unrealized profit. And this unrealized profit will be of, well, first let me tell you, it is actually 490. It is 490. And then you will compute 1,600. And profit margin is how much? 25%. That is equal to 1,000. That is equal to 400. Remember one thing. This will be considered as unrealized profit of Department Y. Because we have computed this unrealized profit on this amount. And similarly, and this amount has been transferred by Department X, this has been transferred by Department Y. So that is why I have written, see here, unrealized profit of Department X, 400. Correct? 400. Similarly, 490 will be considered as unrealized profit of Department Y. So I have written it over here. So in this question, number one, profit margins were not given. We had to compute the same, and profit margin of these two departments were different. So in that case, you have to be a little bit more careful. Now, in 3.4, it is interesting question again. In 3.4, now we have to compute interdepartment. It is a case of interdepartmental transferred goods. Now we have to compute closing as well as unrealized profit on closing as well as opening stock. Why? Many a time a student messes, sir, why you have done in this particular question in this manner? The reason being is that in the question which we have done so far, or in all the question, in all the previous three questions, see here, it is written this line, only in closing stock of manufactured. That means in the previous three question, it was written that in the closing stock, some goods, some interdepartmental transferred goods were there. Even in the question previous to that one, which we did, 3.1, it was written over there that in the closing stock. But now the question which we are doing, or which we would do now, here it is written only this thing, that in the stock, not in the closing stock. This slight difference will change the entire scenario of the question. So whenever in the question it will be written the stock, not closing, the stock, in that case you will have to find out unrealized profit not only in opening stock but in closing stock also. For example, in this case 3.4, Messrs. White & Company has two departments, Department P and Department Q. Department P actually manufactures cloth, and we will see later on, then it supplies the entire cloth to Department Q. In this question, Department P is manufacturing cloth, and whatever cloth it manufactures, it transfers the same to Department Q, and then with the help of that cloth, Q prepares ready-made clothes and then sells it to the customers. Correct? This is the point in this particular question. So, now it is given that the ready-made clothes were made by the firm itself. That means after taking the cloth, the Department Q manufactures the same and then sells it to the other department. The ready-made clothes were made by the firm itself out of clothes supplied by Department P at normal selling price. Very important, when P will supply the cloth to department Q, because in this question, department P is the supplier, correct? It supplies the cloth to department Q and at normal selling price. So again, in this question, you will have to find out selling price from the, profit margin. From the following particulars, prepare departmental trading and profit and loss account. Now, in this question, we are given opening stock, correct? So I will write here opening stock. Figures are in thousands, so I will write here 3150532 because otherwise it will consume lots of space. Purchases, I will cut 3 zeros, so I will be left up with 21,000. And 168, I will write here 1 lakhs, or you can simply write 210 lakh and 1,68,000. Then sales we have written in this manner 4720 23100. And 4725 transfer to department Q. Now department P has transferred 31,50,000. So 3150 I will write over here, and of course towards the debit side I will put it over there. Manufacturing expenses are 6,30,000. I will write it over there. Selling expenses 2,10,000 and 73,500 will be put below. That means in the P&L account. Rent and warehousing you will write over here. And then closing stock at cost to different departments. So closing stock you have written over here. In addition to the above, the following information is made available for necessary consideration. Now in this question, the stock in department Q, it is not written closing stock. Try to understand this. It is written stock in the department. So the stock in the department means it is being referred to both opening and closing stock. Now question states that stock in department Q may be considered as consisting of 75% of the, 75% of the cloth and 25% of other expenses. First of all, we need to understand this particular meaning. In this particular question, let us say closing stock with department Q is 6,72,000. Closing stock. Closing stock. With Q, the closing stock is 6,72,000. I will write here 6,72,000. Rupees 6,72,000. Now question states that 75% of this value, the stock in department Q, may be considered as consisting of 75% of the cloth. If I will compute 75% of this value, 75% of 6,72,000, indirectly it means in the closing stock of department Q comprises of 75% of cloth, means it is interdepartmental transferred goods. So I will compute 75% of this, and it will be equal to how much? 6,72,000 into 75%, that comes to 5,04,000. That means whatever closing stock with you is there, you are department Q. At the end of the current year, you have closing stock of 6,72,000. Now 75% of it is cloth. But it is given in terms of rupee value. That means in terms of rupee value, the rupee value of cloth is equal to 5,04,000. So out of 6,72,000, 5,04,000 worth of goods are interdepartmental transferred goods. Now this line, that the stock in the department of Q may be considered as comprising of 75% of cloth and 25% of other expenses. Now, we are not concerned with 25% of other expenses, because after taking cloth from us, department Q must have spent some amount, correct? So we are not concerned with that. We are concerned only with what amount of this closing stock contains interdepartmental transfer goods, which is equal to 5,04,000. Now you will have to find out your profit margin. You will have to find out your profit margin. Now profit margin, for that you will have to compute your gross profit. Now your gross profit actually is 4200 divided by sales. Sales is equal to 23100 plus transfer of finished goods, and transfer of finished goods is equal to 3150. So you can compute the profit margin in this manner. In this manner, your profit margin will be equal to 23,100 plus 3150. Just wait. It will be equal to 4,200 divided by 26,250 into 100. So 4,200 into 100 divided by 26,250. That comes to exactly 16%. So profit margin is 16%. That means 16% on sales. So your unrealized profit will be equal to this much. Unrealized profit on closing stock, 16% of this, 5,04,000. 5,04,000 into 16%. That comes to 80,640. 80,640 will be considered as unrealized profit. But in this question, not only in the closing stock, even in opening stock, I will have to find. Because here word only the stock is written. It is not written that in the closing stock of department Q. So now I will write opening stock of department Q. Opening stock of department Q we have seen is equal to 5,32,000. Now opening stock of department Q also means this was closing stock of last year. Indirectly it means this is closing stock of last year. You can also say it this way round. This is closing stock of last year, isn't it or not? Anyway. So again, I will compute 75% because question has simply stated that whatever stock of department Q is there, whether it is opening or closing, it comprises 75% of cloth. So I will now compute 5,32,000 into 75%. That is 3,99,000. Now the problem is these goods must have been transferred last year, not in the current year. And in the last year, the goods which Department P must have supplied to Department Q, out of that 5,32,000 worth of goods had remained unsold till the end of the last year. So now we need to find out profit margin of last year. Now how to find that? Profit margin of last year, because for current year we can find. How about what we call last year, profit margin of last year? That will always be given in the question. For example, in this question, it is given. Department P earned a gross profit of 15% in 2019 and 20, that means last year. So you will simply apply 15%. Now 15%, 3,99,000 into 15%, that is equal to 59,850. So first thing is that why we computed unrealized profit on opening and closing stock, because in this question it is written only this, that stock of department Q, it is not written closing stock. So whenever it will be written stock only, then in that case both opening and closing stock will come into picture. So first, now you will go for general profit or loss account. Whatever your net profit of different department is there, you will write that. Now see here. In this question, general expenses I did not divide because here it is written journal expenses of their business as a whole amounted to 10,85,000. Whenever it will be written in this manner, journal expenses as a whole of the business, then in that case, it is better to take the journal expense, what we call directly to the general profit and loss account. So journal expense will come directly over here. Now, unrealized profit of closing stock, which we computed. This is unrealized profit of closing stock, 80,640. Generally, we write it to the debit side, and I have written it to the debit side. Stock reserve or unrealized profit, you can write closing. Correct? This is unrealized profit today. That is why we are debiting it. But tomorrow it will be realized, because this is unrealized profit on closing stock. This closing stock will become opening stock next year. Similarly, the last year's closing stock or opening stock, in other words, is 5,32,000. So unrealized profit on it will be credited, because we shall now presume that this unrealized profit must have been realized in the current year. Correct? So 59,850, you will write it over here. So towards the credit side, the net profit you have written of different department and general expenses you have written, so your profit will be equal to this much. So I hope you got this particular point, why in this particular question we have taken what we call unrealized profit both on opening and closing. Is it clear to you or not? Similarly, there is another question with respect to interdepartmental transfer, and even in this particular question we have to compute what we call unrealized profit on opening and closing stock. This question is similar to the last one which we did. See here, Messrs. Red and Company has two department, P and Q, and the furniture was made by the firm. That means department P supplies timber and department Q prepares for manufactures furniture out of that. So furniture was made by the firm itself out of timber, which is supplied by department P at normal selling price. So again, you will have to compute, and from the following particulars prepare the departmental trading and profit and loss account. Same thing, absolutely same thing. Opening closing stock you will put over here, 3,50,000, correct? Then we have got purchases, 20,15,000. You will write 20,15,000, no problem. Similarly, sales, you will write over here, so many questions we have done. Transfer to department Q. Now, transfer to department Q, you will write over here, and same item will figure, because towards debit side. Correct? After that, in this particular case, we have got manufacturing expenses. So, manufacturing expenses, 60,000. Manufacturing expenses, 60,000 we have written. Selling expenses, 20 and 6,000 we have written. And now the closing stock is given to you. So closing stock, obviously you are going to write here. Closing stock is 2,60,000. At least you can find out your gross profit now. You have found out now 4,85,000. Till up to this stage, there should not be any problem. Problem will be there. Similar to the last question, the stock in the beginning, sorry, the stock in department, once again, see, pay attention, once again it is written the stock, it is not written closing stock. So that means this time stock means both opening and closing stock will be taken into consideration. So similar to the last one, whatever closing stock is there, 75% comprises of timber. So here I have done the working for you. First, opening stock of furniture, we have taken opening stock of furniture, 75% of stock is timber, so that is portion of timber included in furniture supplied by P. Now this is closing stock of this is opening stock of department Q, sorry, opening stock of department Q is 50,000. If we look over here, see, opening stock is 50,000, correct? In this 50,000, 75% is timber, that been interdepartmental transferred goods, that is equal to 37,500. And now you are going to apply your what we call rate, and rate is given to you because we are talking about opening. So rate is given of last year, that is 20%. So 20% will be your 7,500. Now we will come back to the closing stock. The closing stock is actually 2,00,000. So I will compute 75% of 2,00,000 first of all. 75% of 2,00,000, where is Sorry, what is the closing stock of department Q? It is 60,000. Sorry, I told 2 lakh. It is 60,000. 60,000, not 2 lakh. So 60,000 is the closing stock, correct? 60,000 is the closing stock. We will write the closing stock. We will compute 75%. So 75% is actually timber. Timber means interdepartmental transferred goods. That means in the closing stock of department Q, 45,000 worth of goods are interdepartmental transferred goods. Now you will have to find out the gross profit margin. So we have already computed gross profit margin of department P will be computed because P is the department which is transferring the goods. 4 lakh divided by sale and divided by transfer of manufactured goods or finished goods, 3 lakh into 100, that will be equal to 16%. So you will apply 16% of this, it will be equal to 7,200. And similarly, now you can prepare your, so unrealized profit or stock reserve opening is credited while of current years, that is closing, is debited. Then you will write your net profit and general expenses are also there in this particular question. Then you will compute your net profit. So you can easily manage this question, correct? And as a challenge, I will give you 3.6 now. Try to do 3.6 of your own. To be very honest with you, you can do this question, correct? I don't think there is any problem in this particular question. 3.6, you try to do. Try to do. I'm not telling that you should do. And yes, this is the question which you can manage because we have done a question like this before. And you should be in a position to do 3.7, especially if it is solved. And as far as this particular question, again here the word the stock is written. Correct? The word, whenever stock is written, opening and closing stock both will be considered. Even 3.8 you can manage. And if you will allow me to say so, honestly speaking, even 3.9 can be managed. Even 3.9 can be managed. Because we have done now so many questions. Honestly speaking, this section is also over, provided you are able to do 3.6, 3.7, 3.8 and 3.9. Till up to 3.5 I have done. Anyway, shall meet you in the next session and we will discuss regarding 3.6, 3.7 also. Don't worry about that. Correct? So till then, it's goodbye.